Hello everybody, welcome back to Firewatch. Last time we set out to see what had happened to a downed power line, only to find out that someone had cut it, and we thinks that it might be those nudist firework launchers from episode 2. I had to cut it short. I do apologize for the last video being a little short, so today I'm going to give you a little bit longer video, about 45 minutes. And hopefully that'll make up for the fact that episode 3 was a little short. There's just so many distractions. I don't know why. I thought I would be nice and alone today. It's Saturday, but sorry. I got it all taken care of now. So let's find out what's all in the supply box. What is this?
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
And maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
So an antler and a fossilized claw. That's interesting. Loose stone. Can I chuck it at someone? Anything? Anything of interest? Nope, just a rock. Return to nature. What is this? What the hell just happened? That was strange. Photodome. Wait a minute, is that the brand of the camera? It is! That's the camera! Oh my god, what is happening? What is this?
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Okay. Ron and Dave. 6/16/86. Oh, this is an earlier one. Guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shitheel Steve. It's your man, Ron. Went up to check on the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself. More than usual for LOs. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember, when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? What? You saw Chimney Rock. Chimey? Chimney? Chimney Rock. Okay, sorry. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? I'm starting to think that the Forest Service has only picked the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're the cream de la cream. Let's toast to Deb on the spot. Ron. So I don't remember how to open. I'm not gonna do it. I'll look at it another time. So Two Forks. Could he possibly be talking about Brian Goodwin and his dad? Because if Brian wasn't supposed to be here because he's 12, he would probably be hiding, or at least not in plain sight all the time. So that could be that. We could be finding some very interesting information out, guys. Let's get going.
What does she have?
Uh-oh.
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Scared we didn't get it. Devastating.
Devastating? Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Well, at least Delilah's chipper. Got another big open field. Let's find the teens. Where are we at? What is that? Backpack, I guess? Okay, this heads back down to Thunder Canyon. One heads back down to Thunder Canyon, others head towards Wapiti Meadow. What a fucking name. Alright, we're gonna head back towards the lake. So, hopefully, this is the first episode. Hello.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain-link fence?
A chain-link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh. That's weird.
Who are you keeping out? What are they keeping in?
What do you think they're keeping in? What do they not want to have get out of there?
Oh, geez, so many things.
Should I just stop you now?
Maybe loads of hedgehogs.
Okay.
Thousands even, full percentage points of the global hedgehog population.
Uh-huh.
The New Zealand government is up in arms. Where are all the hedgehogs? Well, folks are hiding them all in Wyoming. That's where they are. Who would do that, and why? Haha, that is the real mystery.
Really glad I kept you in the loop. Thanks for all of the high-quality information.
Okay. I'll ask what's up if I talk to someone in the next few days who I think might know.
That was too good. Hedgehogs, thousands!
Do you think those girls could be behind this fence?
Having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
I don't even know how I would get in.
It's really strange that that's out there, by the way.
Yeah, it's weird. Hey, remember that guy from yesterday, the guy I saw hiking home?
Ah, the completely unmotivated vandal.
Yeah, that guy.
Go on.
Maybe he was from this fence place.
From the land of the fence.
Yes.
You know what? I'll make a note. You might be on to something.
Something. Alright, well, clearly they give you this camera for a reason. Cool. Alright. So it looks like it's part of Jonesy Lake, because that sign in there was saying something about Jonesy Lake being in a certain distance. Okay, so, well, that cuts off that way. And once again, look at me. Going the wrong way. I said I was going towards Thunder Canyon, not Wapiti Meadow. One day, guys. One day I won't get lost. Makes me wonder what my next Let's Play is going to be. Maybe I should make it really linear, that way I can't get lost. At least I didn't have to cut anything out this time around. It's very, very helpful. Okay, let's just, you know, make sure I'm going the right way for once in my life, and I actually am, so, carry on. Whoa. Forest fire?
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in the fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there, as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
Left some sort of trail. Gotta find some sort of trail. Where would sloppy naked young women be? Who no longer have any underwear.
So, how'd you meet?
Oh boy, here we go.
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
Hello? Anyone?
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
Rope hook, huh? I don't wanna... I mean, I guess I could just climb back up. Oh, that's what those are. Those are rope hooks. Okay. So these little blue things are rope hooks. That looks like it puts me back on that trail. I don't want to come there yet. I want to explore this other trail first. Or, I guess, not really a trail, it's more of an opening. A path. Not densely populated forest of trees. I don't know, guys. I'm making crap up at this point. Whoa. Ah, there we go. Cut! Well, Henry hasn't broken anything since we started our journey, so we got that going for us. Okay. What is beyond this area? Another fucking rope hook. Ah, great. Okay, so now comes the fun part. I have to go back, I'm guessing, to the fire trail? Or the, not the fire trail, the place with the fire, and find some hints. So, with that being said, I don't think I'm going to make you guys sit through this. So I'm going to, wait, what was that? What was this?
Do you see anything from yours, like, you know, clues as to where they could be?
Clues. I really like your enthusiasm for mystery.
I'm just doing my job.
I like it. I do. I can't wait for you to give these girls a piece of our minds collective. But no clues. I can't see anything from here.
Okay. Yeah. After that, I'm going to cut this out. Hopefully I find what's going on. So, I will see you guys shortly.
What are you going to do when the fire season wraps up?
You bastard.
Are you going to go be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents... I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
Come on, Hank! Alright. Hopefully no more dialogue. I'm going to cut it here. And hopefully I find something. So, I'll see you guys soon.
Did your wife's illness have anything to do with you taking this job? Or did you just fall prey to the service's big recruiting push? When it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here?
Fucking Delilah.
Sorry, I don't really know what you mean by recruiting effort.
Oh, after last summer. You know, budgets went through the roof, a lookout, and every lookout for the first time in 20 years.
Last summer?
Oh, come on, you're from Denver, not Delaware. This was national news, for Pete's sake.
Boulder. I'm from Boulder.
Same diff.
So are you going to let me know what happened that caused this budget increase, or what?
Wow. I can't believe you don't know.
I was a little preoccupied last summer.
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
Yellowstone is, like, what, 15 miles away? Why would they do that?
Well, the short story is that for 60 years, we got very good at not letting forest fires happen. And then about 15 years ago, they decided that forest fires in wilderness areas like Yellowstone should be left to burn. So that's what they did. I can't believe you didn't hear about this. There were reports that the entire park was gone. Dan Rather telling the country that President Reagan didn't care on the nightly news? And what the hell's he gonna do? Smoke jump in and snuff one out for the Gipper?
So what should they have done?
I don't even know. By the time the Yellowstone folks realized the little fires weren't going to burn themselves out, 100,000 acres were gone.
Holy shit.
It's Yellowstone, you know? People don't want to touch it. But we touch it every single day. But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco. Like the goddamn park can burn down again.
All right, so I searched. Seriously? I just spent like 10 minutes searching that entire area, and it's right here.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
Hike towards where?
Holy shit! Oh my lord. Okay, well, it's a good thing this episode's gonna be longer. Why can I not attach the rope to the hook? Game? No, seriously, but, like, I spent, like, 10, 15 minutes searching that entire fire area. Delilah kept talking to me. Let's see if this does it. Okay, well, can't take that one, so we're clearly gotta take the other one. So, yeah, that was great. But at least we have a place to go now. I just gotta find a way to get there, that's all. I'm gonna cut this out. I know, a lot of cuts, I'm sorry, but I don't wanna make you guys... Okay. I don't wanna make you guys keep watching me run through the same area, so I'll be back! Alright, so... I know that cut was very strange, but I had to sit down and think for a solid probably 10 minutes, figure out why I can't get down off this rope hook. It would be because the person controlling the mouse and keyboard is an idiot, and you need to walk a little bit more forward. Holy crap, that just goes to show how stupid I truly, really am. Alright, just to let you guys know, in the time I was down, I also went and put the rope down on this guy right here, that rope hook. That was how I figured out how basically stupid I was. Just letting you guys know. So let's continue our journey. We're gonna stop them. Angsty teens. And we have a very, very, very long hike.
Wow, I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
I'd look at Hank in a jumpsuit. Okay. Now that that's over with... we can finally continue our journey. I can't believe I feel so stupid, and I'm just gonna feel stupid all day now. Oh, I love when games do that to me. Well, it's not even the game's fault, it's really my fault. Just being a dum-dum. That's pretty much all there is to say. Whatever. No reason to dwell on it in the video. So now... oh my god. Okay, so we're basically just going to... Shitty Boss is getting Get Me Killed Hill. I think that is where I need to go. So let's go to the very well-named Shitty Boss is going to Get Me Killed Hill. Oh my, okay. So I've also learned something, that there's very, very, very few times in this game where you can actually cut and just leave it all out. Because every time I say I'm going to cut, except for when I start the video, it's pretty much Delilah's going to start talking to me eventually. So, I'm going to keep cuts to a minimum. And you guys are just going to have to deal with me as I walk through this beautiful, beautiful game. Alright, so we're back at the cash box. Pretty much just follow this trail down to the shale hill. And that will get me, hopefully, to where I need to go. I think it was this way? I'm gonna look at my map and find out I'm completely wrong, aren't I? Ha! Joke's on you, game! I solved you. Okay, it's over there. Thin column of smoke. That's a big fucking plume of smoke for a campfire. Again, I'm probably the least qualified person to speak on campfires, seeing as I've never gone camping in my life. That's okay, it's not really for me.
Well, I'm back at my shitty boss is gonna get me killed hill.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
I don't blame you one bit, Henry. But at least we have some rope this time that hopefully won't snap on us. Please. 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 Golden. Cool. We did it. We did it, Reddit! We lived. Okay, let's take a gander at the good old map. So, there should be an opening coming up to the left, and that's where I'm going to want to go. Because down there is where they... Oh, it's a campsite. It's marked in the map already. It must be, like, general camping areas for hikers and such. So I'm probably going to have to go to that little green arrow in that general direction. So I should be coming up to something on my left relatively soon. And I would be right. Let's get down this here shale hill number 2. There's a lot of shale in this area. Wyoming, you're a very strange state, aren't you? Cool. Should be coming up on a river or a creek. Should be. Doesn't mean I will. Looks like it's starting to get dusk out. Sun's starting to go down. What do we got? Changed the color of my map. Whoa, that's cool. Need a little effect. Alright, so I just keep heading straight to find the cash box. So we find the cash box, we're pretty much almost there. I wonder what piece of animal we'll find in this one, guys! There you are. What we got? Learn to live with bears. Missing person.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately.
Mitch Michaels.
Most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
You really didn't like that guy, did you?
I don't know. I honestly, I just had a hard time talking to him. I mean, there are lookouts who seriously won't shut up, who call me about every little thing that pops into their head. And then there are those who just want to be left alone. He was the latter.
And I'm the former, aren't I?
Well, I didn't want to say anything.
No, it's fine. I'll just chuck my walkie-talkie into the river.
Oh, come on.
And you'll never hear from me again.
Finally, peace and quiet. Woohoo!
So...
Isn't your radio supposed to be in the river?
I couldn't bring myself to do it.
Well, I guess I'm stuck with you then.
Yeah. You said Ned didn't get mauled by a grizzly, but it's possible, right?
Yeah, I guess it's possible, but we usually find evidence of stuff like that. For instance, if you were to be hunted down and torn to shreds, I'm sure someone would come across a bloody beard and shredded pair of ugly cargo shorts.
I like these shorts.
I'm sure you do, Henry.
I'm sure you do, Henry. There's that witty writing.
Well, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root
organism. Oh my god,
look
at this lighting.
Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things?
Oh my god.
Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Yep, Yep, we are, but look at this lighting! Oh my god, this is beautiful! I wish I had a computer capable of running this game at full. Holy crap, this is gorgeous. Alright, let's get going. I don't want to leave. Can I just live here? Can I move my tower? Upstream. Oh, I said this was going to be a river. It's basically just a slight body of water. Oh, music. I'm just gonna stop talking, guys, and we're just gonna listen to this gorgeous music.
Found one of their empties, because we're on the right track.
Roger that.
There's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. Campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's another one of those magazines.
Top hunks, ranked and rated. Tame your hunk? Oh my god.
These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
Oh, look.
Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like.
That is a very small tent.
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking. Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
What is this?
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay. Yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Well, dear psychos. Dear psycho, I hope you're fucking happy we're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about you creeping on us at the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. Hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. Heart. I like the red, but stole panties. So it wasn't the girls. I'm just gonna hold it to myself.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
planning to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, it just cuts right to day three. Very interesting. So, it wasn't them. They cut it because the stolen panties, it makes sense. Find boards downstairs. They also weren't in it because they came back
to... Hey,
Henry. Oh.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Like Burt Reynolds. If Tom Cruise has a good-looking twin, do you know Raleigh Fingers? We're gonna go with Tom Cruise.
This isn't that hard.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5'0".
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes. I don't really think about it. Oh, baby, let's go.
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, Dale, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
I have a thick beard, my nose has been broken. You'll enjoy my thin mustache and long scar.
Well, I have a thin mustache, real thin mustache. I got a long scar, goes down across my eye and down my cheek.
And you only wear tuxes?
Yeah.
Are you a freaking Bond villain?
I get up to some stuff, yeah.
I don't think you're taking this very seriously. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Oh,
your
no.
What?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm going to do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Steely, happy, tired.
They're steely. Cold, hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Oh, and that window is all patched up. So, Jesus. What should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Okay, well, I'm going to spend some time looking at these books because now I'm very curious about that thing we found in the cache. Don't mind your mind alone. Have you considered the untapped power of your own mind? Do you often ponder the unexplainable? Do you find yourself seeing in which it is not there? Do you want to explore? Blah, 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 blah. So that's all about mind, which makes sense because she has dementia. Death strikes at 2. Oh, it's another Richard Sturgeon. Oh, what is this? One dance to die. Two bodies, zero leads. Also on the job. There are over 3 million Richard Sturgeon books. Where does this take place? Come on, there's got to be something here. Hold on 1 second, guys. Sorry about that once more. People just love to disturb me when I'm recording. Maybe one day I'll actually get to play a game when I don't get interrupted. But wait, the Patriots? Oh, wait. Okay, this is the Donald Trump book. Let's take a look. Anything? Dead Runda. No. Okay, we gotta look for the Sturgis books. That is not what I wanted to do with that by any means. Glory? I can't read that one at all. And finally this one, Birds of Wyoming. George Sinclair. Can't read it. Okay. So, what is this? Look at that face. It's adorable. Oh, they block out her face. Okay. Well, I guess we're ready to work. What's up with us for day three?
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
You know, I'm gonna hike around for a while before I really put my nose to the grindstone.
Oh, yeah, you do that.
I didn't know what that would be, so.
Okay, now I'm ready. Let's get to work.
How were those precious few seconds of jobless freedom?
Oh, magical.
Good. Now get to work.
What do I do? Oh. Day 9.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Whoa, that's not what I wanted. Sorry, guys.
I might never leave.
Well, I called with some bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
Oh. Damn it! I'm sorry, guys. I keep pressing the wrong key.
Yeah, don't.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
All right. I know. I'm sorry. Oh my god, day 15, what is happening?
Henry? Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Delilah, I'm sleeping.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
What?
You're a big dumb idiot.
Oh, baby, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
What is happening? It's good here. Fine, somewhere to...
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
What is happening? What is happening? Hike north through a
tree. Is it too much
supplies?
Of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Okay.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. So, I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Wow, that was some deep shit.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
3, thank you. 4, what do we got? Hello. Oh, nice. Food for other lookout I can take. I like it. 3 for 2 forks, supply lookout.
Alright, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Oh my god, what is happening? Okay. What the hell is that?
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
How about the big fire? The flapjack fire? What about Delilah? Oh, man.
So, no ideas, huh?
Maybe we call it the flapjack fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack fire it is. You'll probably ask me if it was a camp cooking accident or something.
Flapjack fire.
So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Oh my god.
I've had one too many bad experiences with tequila. I'm a little reticent to try it again.
Well, maybe you just need a new, good experience with it.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, guys.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
Good. I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk about these radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Oh, come on, that's no fair.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Oh my goodness.
That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Bear, fuck. Huh.
Problem bear, fuck that. I am of the opinion that they are all problems.
Come on, please.
Ugh. Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this game is pretty great. Alright guys, that was a long episode. I didn't know we were going to be skipping so many days, but I think we're going to call it here for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you're still enjoying this as much as I am. Please leave a like, dislike, whichever you feel this video deserves. Leave a comment if you let me know what you guys liked, what you guys didn't like, all that kind of fun stuff. Or if you just want to start chit chat with me, it's all cool. Also, subscribe if you want to see what's going to happen next on this Firewatch and what else I'm doing. Thank you guys once again for watching, and I will see you next time. Have a great night.